2 weeks ago, their diplomatic to and fro produced this white paper. Its main proposals that Smith should surrender power to the British, that the UN should come in to help the British commissioner maintain law and order, that a new Zimbabwe National Army be created, that a new constitution, including an entrenched Bill of Rights, should be included, that democratic elections would be held in 1978 to find a new government for the independent Zimbabwe, and that the West should provide £1,000 million or so to revive the economy, money which could also, of course, be used to help those whites who wanted to leave the country. Do you support the Anglo-American proposals?
The short answer is yes, I do. I honestly believe that the present proposals, a base for negotiations, a good base, I believe, a good base for negotiations to reach a settlement.
So President Nyerere gives his crucial blessing to the proposals. A blessing that hinges, however, on a fundamental concession that he won from the British at the very last moment. The issue is the army. The white paper simply states that a new Zimbabwe National Army will in due course replace all existing armed forces in Rhodesia.
Two armies now confronting one another. And the Smith army really has to go. And the new army of Zimbabwe has to be based on the liberation forces.
And it is clear to you that when Dr. Owen has said that the new army will be based on liberation forces, that implies the complete dismantlement of the Smith army, as you put it.
Well, I'm saying one army has to go. This is the meaning of this confrontation. If this war were to go on for the next 2, 3, 4, 5 years, Smith and his army will have to go. If you want to shorten it, Smith and his army will still have to go, only that it takes shorter. So we have emphasized that the new army of independent Zimbabwe can no longer be the Smith army. It can only be an army created out of the liberation forces. But this does not exclude the new government from including in this army, whose base is the liberation forces, including in that army acceptable elements of the Smith forces.
Was it a condition of your accepting the Anglo-American proposals that the new state should have forces based on the Liberation Army?
Oh yes, if they are rejected by Smith because he insists he must have the army and he regards this army as the issue, and he says since on the basis of these proposals the new army of Zimbabwe must be based on the Liberation Forces which you call the terrorists, if he rejects them on that basis, then it will be a fight to the end. Be fighting to the end. This army has to be built to fight to the end until that army is defeated. It will take much longer to defeat that Smith army. But it will be defeated. By the time it is defeated, I don't believe there is going to be very much of a future for white men in Zimbabwe. I don't believe so.
So, President Nyerere warns the whites against fighting on to the end, warning them in essence against the consequences of a military defeat by the guerrillas who form the Patriotic Front. From today's papers, you might have thought that the leaders of the Patriotic Front, Joshua Nkomo, based in Zambia, and Robert Mugabe, based in Mozambique, had rejected the white paper. But yesterday afternoon, I spoke with Mugabe in Mozambique. Is that white paper a basis for negotiation or not?
Certainly, yes. This is a basis for discussion. And we ourselves have examined it, analyzed the various provisions, and we've now come out with our reaction to the proposals.
There is no sense, then, in which your reaction, as it was described and has been described during the last 2 weeks, constitutes an absolute rejection of the proposals.
We have examined the proposals, and we note in the proposals that there is an acceptance by Britain for example, of the principle of independence as a non-negotiable right of the people of Zimbabwe, that the British, in agreement with us, are for democratic elections.
Is there anything in the proposals which is wholly unacceptable, which would impede your participation in the transition period which would lead to independence?
The transitional period is, the power structure of the transitional period is completely ridiculous. We cannot allow ourselves to be outmaneuvered during the transitional period.
Does that mean that unless there is substantial change, you will not take part in the process that might lead towards those elections?
That's quite true. Unless the British revise this power structure of the transitional period, we cannot see ourselves participating in any elections at all. The crucial issue here is whether Britain will, alongside us, lead the country to independence, or whether she alone would like to do so. And our reading of the proposals is that Britain, in fact, would like to exclude us from the process of leading the country to independence. This, of course, we cannot accept.